Not that one.
What is it? Not that one?
No, that's not on my property.
Huh?
That's not on my property.
Oh. I think it's a single thing.
It's right behind you.
This?
No. No, look. The one that's dead.
Oh, I see it. Oh, yeah. That's a good size one.
I think the vines that were growing on it killed it. I cut all the vines down, but
yeah, I mean, look. Back. Look at the top. That's dead up there.
Yeah. That's one of the vines.
Yeah, that's huge. It's like an anaconda.
Yeah. I don't know if I want to take down the little one next to it.
I would.
You would?
Yeah, I would.
Yeah, it's probably not going to do much there, huh?
Well, I mean, how many trees you want? Here's the other thing. I mean, you take this one down, that little one is still going to be growing into this big one. Of course, it'll probably be in a different house by then.
Yeah, that's true. They're not going to survive together.
Maybe, is it? I think maybe I should put some safety glasses on.
I think it's going to get hung up on this tree.
All right. It feels like it wants to go now.
Come over quite a bit. It's not rocket. The vines.
Here it comes.
I think I'm going to try raising these up, the guides up, so I don't have quite as much down pressure. And the other thing I'm going to do is I'm using this old blade that might still have some life in it, but it started cutting. Yeah, see, it's not quite sharp, but it might be sharp enough to cut some green wood. But it started cutting at angles and going in and out through the wood. And I want to see if I really crank down on this thing and tension this blade, you know, properly. Will it last longer? Can I get some more cuts out of this? So, yeah, we'll see what happens. Now, I'm just measuring this for a baseline because what I'm going to do is I'm just going to crank on this thing. And I haven't looked up actually what the proper tension is for this blade, but at least this will give me a reference. And okay, so the idea is this metal is going to stretch. And I'm going to see this 5 inches change, maybe only like a few thousandths probably, but I'm going to really crank on this thing and see what happens. We need a little advantage here. Okay, This is much tighter than I've had it. Oh, wasn't quite there all the way. Okay. Well, there goes my sump pump. Okay. I think I want to go for like 2/1000ths over 5 inches. Oh, come on. There we go. 2/1000ths. If you can see that. Okay, so over 5 inches, the blade stretched 2/1000ths. Okay. 0.002 divided by 5, and then you multiply that by 29 million. I think. And that's how many PSI are on this blade. So I have 11,600 PSI on the blade. And I could figure out what the cross section is of this and then figure out how many pounds that equates to. But this is tighter than I've had it before. So I think, let me just give it a shot. And I gotta clean. Man. Oh, this log got muddy, which is not what you want, because all that sand and dirt's gonna kill the blade even faster. Okay. Yeah, I thought it dove down a little bit. I don't know if you can see, but definitely a gap. Okay. See, it started off nice and close, but the blade dove down, because now on the return you can see it's higher than the wood was. What I really want is it for it to be barely just dragging along there, which means that I would have gotten a straight cut. All right, so I've made a mark on the blade with a Sharpie here, and I'm just going to touch the outer part of the tooth with this Dremel. And I know nothing about sharpening saw blades, so this could just ruin this blade. And if you guys know how to sharpen these, or if you have a method, please let me know, because I'm just going into this blind. So I figure if it's already dull, I can't do too much damage. But more importantly, if this doesn't work, I'll know that I'm probably not going to want to spend my time sharpening saw blades, because if I have to do this manually and it's like takes any longer than just touching it with a Dremel, I'm not interested. So maybe it'll work, maybe it won't. Let's try it. All right. Bit more of a crank. All right. That is not 3/4 of an inch. That is going to be scrap wood. Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at it brushing the sawdust back. Oh, yeah, that's what we want. All right, so I don't know if... I think it was more the sharpening the blade that got it to go straighter, because I didn't tighten it that much more. All right, so I lowered it another inch, and let's see how she does. That is more than an inch. That is like an inch and 3/16. Started out an inch exactly. And I can see there's a still a waviness to it. Yeah. Yeah, it's not terrible, but yeah, it's certainly riding on that wood. One thing I noticed was there is some buildup on the blade and on the guide bearings, so maybe that's throwing off the spacing and making it plunge down into the wood a little bit, like directing the blade down just a little bit. So I adjusted the blade guide up just a hair, so see if that makes a difference. Oh, horrible. All right, well, it's cutting boards, but having that same problem where it's going all wobbly and I can't keep it straight in this wide cut. So rather than fight it, and this makes sense for me anyway, I'm gonna cut some narrower boards out of this. Hopefully, I should still get some nice wood out of this. All right, so not a bad haul. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed. This was a video that I was really excited to make, and it took a long time because we cut the tree down in the fall and then winter came and we got a lot of snow and I threw my back out and all this stuff happened. So it was a few months before I was able to get back out here and set the saw up and mill down some boards from that tree. But it's just really cool to me to be able to cut a tree down in my own backyard, mill it up with a sawmill that I built myself from scratch, and I've got all this awesome lumber now from it that just, I mean, I don't know. I can't explain it. It's just really cool. As always, thanks for watching. I really like your comments, so leave them down below. Things I did right, things I did wrong, your experiences, room for improvement, videos you want to see even. So leave a comment down below, hit the like button, And if you're not subscribed already, hit subscribe, and we'll see you next time.